Hi, I'm Michael Buchwalder. You join me today on a glorious summer's day for a bit of roach fishing at Thursday Lake in Milton Keynes. I'm going to run you through my tactics to catch more roach, especially trying to sort of show you how to fish hemp really well. It's a really complicated thing to fish. Your rigs need to be right, you need to hook it right, and all your feeding needs to be right. Get these correct and you catch a beautiful net of fish. I'm going to show you my ground baits first of all. I always like to start with a real active mix fishing for roach, so I've used super feeder with some black roach. I've mixed it quite wet, try and get it down and try and stop the particles going as mad as they do. But what also I've done is I've added some F1 2mm pellets soaked up. You're thinking, why have I done that fishing for roach on hemp? Problem is with hemp doesn't always go, you need a backup plan, and being like a top match angler you need to start thinking about things the way you're doing it. So by putting some pellets in, there's going to be pellets in the bottom, hopefully they'll stay there, the skimmers will turn up if I don't catch roach. I've got the hemp, I've got the Sonu hemp in a tin. Being a busy man, I've no time to sit and cook hemp at night time, young kids now, so I've been using the hemp here. It's actually perfect, it splits perfectly, and there's also a lot of hookers in there, so you haven't got to spend time cooking it. All of you stay straight out of the tin in there and added more water. I watch some people fish hemp and they don't add water to the actual seed pot. Problem is if it starts to dry out even slightly, it starts to float and doesn't settle properly like all the other grains. So big important tip, that is, add water to it. The other big important tip, add a few pellets, especially on commercials like this, because you never know, hemp might not work and you need a backup plan. I'm going to show you how I started fishing today. I'm a big believer in being positive at start fishing on big open venues like this. I've stood up and I've thrown six balls in like that over quite a big area, not down the same old, maybe two or three dustbin lids. Get a big bed of feed down and I've started pinging hemp, like not twos and threes, like three quarters of a pouchfuls at a time. Maybe get through three tins in a 5 hour session, so real positive fishing. But I've always put a bit of ground bait down, it's a big bed, it gives me somewhere to fish over the whole time. After the initial boarding session, I've not tried hemp straight away, it's not gonna get a bite for at least an hour, so don't waste your time. I've gone in with double maggot, double pinky, and bits of worm on the hook, trying to pick off maybe 2 or 3 pounds of fish quickly before the roach turn up. As it's happened today, I've gone in and caught 4 or 5 skimmers, maybe 6 ounces apiece, quite a few pommies. And after an hour, sipped a grain of hemp on, gone out there, it's gone dump straight down, and we've caught a fish and chub on hemp for the last probably hour and 45 minutes. This is nearly always the way of hemp fishing. The second part of the match is always better than the first half. For some reason, whether it's like a drug to them or something, hemp never seems to work straight away unless you're on an absolute pile. So always prep your peg, catch as many different fish as you can with the mindset of the last 2 hours you're going to look to catch on the hemp and build your way up that way. Quickly going to go show you through my rig for fishing for these roach on Thursday Lake. I'm going to start at the top, work my way down. Number 6 elastic through just one section. Don't need any more. Don't want elastic everywhere from your peg or do it because I'm a bit bigger. 011 AccuPower down to an interfloat, 0.3 of a gram. Running down, I've got using stops on here. I want to try and slow me forward up a bit. Hemp fishing is all about getting the bite, and the quicker you get the bite, the quicker you catch your fish. So it's all about the rig settling correctly. What I'm making a little bulk of 4 of them, number 10s, then equally spaced out, 3 of them down there. Got a bit of a longer hook length because I'm fishing the hemp. It's a bit more finicky, so I don't want a 4 or 6 inch hook length. Drop it on, that's about 10 inches that is, straight on there. Got a number 11 stot on there just to make it a little bit presentation better for myself. Got 09 AccuPower down to an N10 size 18. Not too big, not too small. I'd generally right hook to start, you can put maggot on it, hemp on it, caster, a bit of worm, sort of an all-round sort of size to start with. Started bagging on maybe the hemp and that. Maybe say it's up to a 14 if it was black, or even down to a 22 if it was really hard. But for a starting rig, that's perfect. Obviously, if the conditions are nowhere near as good as today, it's blowing a bit, then probably up that to a 0.6, even up to a gram. It's all about your presentation. If your float's doing this and your hook bait's doing this, you're not going to catch. So your rig needs to suit the conditions. And today, being virtually flat calm, there's a breeze picked up now, but not a lot. 0.3 and 0.6 be perfect every single time. Another important thing fishing with hemp fishing, especially roach, as you want. You don't want this. You don't want a lighthouse hanging out the top of the water where you bite, you can't see anything. I have this virtually, so you can't see it. Just, it's a bit of a dot on the surface, maybe a bit of bristle grease on there to hold it up in that last little bit. Problem with bristle grease, if it does get on the line sometimes, you have to keep moving it off, but the benefits outweigh the negatives. So have it dotted right down, every bite becomes magnified. There's two ways to hook hemp. My preferred method is I like to slot it down the kernel into the end of it and just nip it in tight. The second way is pinning hemp. I'm going to run through both of them now and show you the best way I think it should be hooked. The best method for me is slotting the hemp. It's as simple as this. Find a grain, a little bit slit. People say hooking hemp takes a long time. For me, what's that? Half a second it's on there. As long as you pick the right grains out, very, very simple. The second way of hooking hemp is to pin it. I use our disgorger as a knot picker. You quickly stab the bottom, one little pop through. Best way of doing this though is if you get 20 or 30 minutes before the start of the match, just quickly pop them all through, pin them all, and they're ready to go. It's pinned that way. For me, this way is perfect if you're missing loads and loads of bites, as you haven't got to bring your hemp in all the time and change it. But the downside is when the fish are a bit finicky and you bump one, they're not having it funny, the hemp sometimes stays on, so your hook hole's not as good. So the way I prefer to fish is I prefer it to come off, be quicker at hooking it, and not risk bumping fish. So there's both ways, but definitely nice fine point on the picker, and maybe pick out 20 or 30 grains, pin them first if you're going to do it that way. You haven't got to mess around the match. The other part of hemp fishing is loose feeding. At the start of a session, I always like to put a fair bit of bait in. That's what I'd feed every single chuck for maybe an hour, and depending on how the bites were coming. I see some guys feeding two or three grains maybe on real difficult rivers like Evesham, but for me, I want to put a bit of bait in, and once they start turning up and you start getting bites, then maybe cut it down to maybe that many grains of hemp. But at the start, you can't catch them unless they're in your pegs, you need to attract them in. So attract them in the peg, then cut them down and make them competitive to feed for the bait. But at the start, definitely I feed like that. One of the biggest things with hemp fishing is how your rig's laid in. There's no point dropping it in a big heap. It needs to be laid in to left or right, depending which way it's towing. So if it's towing right to left, lay your rig in left-hand side, vice versa if it's towing the opposite way. Once it's settled, maybe 5 to 10 seconds in the water, you need to move your rig. It's very similar to F1 fishing, really. Probably if the F1 guys come and did hemp fishing, be really good at it. Got to be busy. So quite often I lift my float maybe that much out of the water, like bloodworm fishing and pellet fishing. Lift it up, tilt it to the side a little bit, lower it in. The amount of bites you get just it settles is amazing. If you sit there, you won't get the bite. And again, if two or three times that doesn't work, you lift your rig out, lay it in again, hold it tight, and the amount of times it goes on, it goes dunk. Really, really interesting fishing. And the best anglers are always the busiest anglers. Here's the result. 20 pounds plus of perfect roach and a few skimmers. Odd little hybrid to start. Does summertime fishing on the pole get any better than this? Follow my simple tips to hemp fishing. You too will end up catches like this. Let's get them back.